Hello healers, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. This is another flip through and it's for the archetype cards Caroline Miss. Okay, this is an interesting deck I saw in my friend's Nat channel. She has the channel Spiritual Guidance with Nat. I'll leave her link below for you to check her out. Lovely channel. I saw this in her video and it's really interesting because this deck was showing up in my life like a few different times. Okay, I was seeing online, I was seeing in other videos, and then I saw in her channel, and then I went on my local crystal shop and I saw there as well. And then I was thinking, yes, I do have to take this deck. Is showing up over and over for me. So here it is. It is actually an 80 cards deck with the guidebook as well. 80 cards, guys, loads of cards here, and it's a very interesting concept. Okay, I opened already and I had a quick look on them because they are so interesting and different. Okay, and like Kanat was saying in her channel, it's really interesting to use for picker cards if you wanted to find information about the person. Okay, because this here, it's all about the archetype. Okay, it comes in this very sturdy box. You can see here it's Hay House. Okay, and it's very interesting. Okay, I'll read here for you. Caroline Miss is a pioneer in the field of energy medicine and human consciousness. Okay, since 1982, she has worked as a medical intuitive, one who sees illness in a patient's body by intuitive means. Okay, so it's very interesting. With this guidebook here, this instruction booklet accompanying the archetype cards explain how to use the cards to help determine which archetype are most active in your psyche and how they can lead you to achieve greater insights into your life. So I feel like this is very interesting to see which one is the archetype that is really in our lives at the moment, or the way I'm going to use here with the picker cards is to see which one is really representing that person at the time. Because you will see here, this is the back, okay, it's a lot of orange bright colors here, and it's a good quality, okay, shiny. But you will see here the way they show here. Okay, for example, we have the addict, okay, and then you have the light attribute and the shadow attribute of every card. Okay, every card, there are all kinds of you know, attributes here that you can find like about the person. And I feel like this can be very interesting with picker cards when you're trying to see who is that person. Okay, we're trying to see where they are at the moment, what's going on in their lives, or who they are if you don't know who, if you're talking about someone, you're trying to just find out more about that person and what's going on in their lives. Okay, what's ruling their lives at the moment. Because you can see here, like the addict, you have the light attribute. Helps you recognize and confront addictive behavior. Or the shadow attribute, okay, compromises integrity and honesty, allows an addictive patterns to have authority over your inner spirit. So it could be that the person is on the shadow side at the moment, or you know, what can you do to help them. So it's very interesting, many interesting words, and 80 cards, guys, a lot here. And then at the end they have some blank ones that you can add on for yourself as well. Just very nice. As you can see, advocate, and the light attribute inspires you to put compassion into action, or the shadow attribute, embracing negative causes or committing to causes for personal gain. You see, you can see where this person is at the moment, or who they are, or more information about their character as well. Okay, we have the alchemist, the angel, and the artist. Okay, there are loads of here, athlete. Okay, you can see more information about their character. Okay, so Avenger, Beggar, we have Bully. There's negative and positive for every single card. You see, there's some with like Child Divine, Child Eternal, Child Magical. Try to do this quick, guys, because it's 80 cards. Child Nature, Child Orphan. I'll read some of them. Okay, light attributes, independence based on learning to go it alone, conquering fear over surviving, or the shadow light, which is feeling of abandonment that stifle maturation, seeking inappropriate surrogate families. Very interesting. You can see child wounded, we have companion. The light attribute is loyalty, tenacity, and unselfishness, but the shadow light is betrayal by misusing confidence's loss of personal identity. Can see, guys, how we can really do some interesting readings here. Denzel, and we have Destroyer. I feel like you can have some readings for us as well, okay? Like thinking on introspection, okay? Anything that you may need to work on at the moment. Detective. Dilettante. Don Juan. You can see here, the Don Juan spotlights your positive, seductive qualities, or the shadow, using the power of romantic attraction for private agendas. Let's see, guys. You can find that, I feel like, more information about someone's personality, or even our one, anything that we need to work on, okay? The shadow side, the light side, engineer, exorcist, father. So it could be that you're embracing that kind, or someone else, okay? If you're asking about someone else. Femme fatale, fool, gambler, god, goddess, gossip, guide. I feel like so much. It's alphabetic order here. Healer. I can take the guidebook and read one of them, okay? We can get at the end. Hedonist. Something for us maybe to focus on, or just to learn a little bit more about. Hermit. Hero, herring. Judge, King, Knight, Liberator. So the light side is the light attribute, feeling yourself and others from outmoded beliefs, releasing negative thought patterns. And the shadow attribute, imposing your own tyranny over those you claim to liberate, ignoring legitimate constraints. Interesting. The lover, great passion and devotion, unbridled appreciation of someone or something. Shadow attributes, obsessive passion that harms others, self-destructive devotion. See here, guys, very, very interesting. Martyr, mediator, mentor, messiah, leaders, miser. Monk or nun, mother, mystic, networker, interesting pictures, pioneer. I wish the pictures were bigger, but I understand there's so much information as well here. Poet, priest, prince, prostitute. I'll read this, guys, so I don't think it's something really bad, because it's light and shadow. And we have accentuate the challenge of surviving without negotiating the power of your spirit. And the shadow places material considerations and security above self-empowerment. Interesting. Queen, rebel, rescuer, saboteur. And there is, I was reading in the book, we have like definitely four of them on us. All the time, Samaritan, scribe, seeker, thirst for wisdom and truth wherever they are, and the shadow side is inability to commit to a path once found. Interesting. Servant, shapeshifter, slave, storyteller, student, teacher, thief, trickster, vampire, makes you aware that someone or something is draining your life force, or the shadow, depleting others from your psychic survival, chronic complaining and codependency. Interesting. Victim, virgin, visionary, warrior, and those are the empty cards that you can add more things that you find out about yourself or others, which is very nice as well. I can see here six extra ones, so it's 74 cards plus the six empty ones that you can add. I'm gonna just mix here, guys, to see if there's something from the guidebook that you can take. Okay, there's a lot of cards here, guys, you know. And maybe this one, jump it out. Engineer. Let's find out more about the engineer, okay? The light attributes, ability to give creative energy a practical expression, talent for designing resolutions, two common dilemmas. Shadow, reliance on mechanistic solutions without regard of emotional consequences. Interesting. So I believe it's alphabetic order. Just finding here for us. And you can see here, guys, the guidebook is a full page for each. Okay, don't mind my things writing here in my hands, guys. Okay, so engineer. Okay, engineer, you can see here, one full page. And you have different things, okay, like different words. You can see here the architect, builder, designer, schemer, grounded, orderly, strategic qualities, give creative energy a practical expression. Talent for engineering, everyday situations, or designing solutions to common dilemmas. Shadow engineer manifests as a master manipulator, designing solutions to one's own advantage, regardless of the needs of others. Look for a pattern of designing and building structures, devices, or solutions. You can see here, guys, it's interesting, you know, straightforward, all the positives and negatives. It could be the way for us to check positives and negatives of someone, or, you know, like I said, anything that we are trying to find about ourselves as well. And very colorful, okay? I like the colors. I like that side. The images are not so big, but still, I like, anyway, not my first choice, like, I wish it was bigger, but it's still, I feel like the idea behind the guidebook has much to offer. So I feel like it can really be helpful here for us to try to understand where we are, someone, you know, positive, negative of a situation, and what we can do here. Okay, interesting. Guys, this is what I have here for you. I try to leave this short, but this is always a bit long, isn't it? But yeah, I'll leave this for you, okay? And if you like this deck, like always, the details will be below, okay? Loads of cards here. There's loads of information you can get here as well. And all the information below. If you like this video, let me know. Leave me a comment. As always, I wish you a lovely, blessed, and healing day. Thanks for watching.